Next, I will show how to apply the two-paired means t procedure to test a statistical claim about two-paired population means. Consider the following example. A local group of economists wants to study the effects of the pandemic on the small businesses in their city. A survey was sent out to a random sample of 100 small businesses to anonymously report their weekly earnings throughout March and April. Only 10 businesses provided enough data to compute their average weekly earnings for 2 months. Use 5% significance level to test the claim that the weekly earnings of small businesses have decreased during the pandemic. Note that the sample means and the sample standard deviations for each sample can be easily computed. However, it appears that there is a clear pairing between the samples, since it is the same 10 businesses for which the data was obtained in March and April. So we are not interested in the differences between the two samples, but in the sample of the differences. So we turn two samples into one, with the sample mean $3,920 and sample standard deviation $1,320. Now let's identify the statistical claim that needs to be tested. The claim is that the weekly earnings of small businesses in March are greater than the weekly earnings of small businesses in April. So we can symbolically express the claim as mu1 is greater than mu2. Or equivalently as mu1 minus mu2 is greater than 0, or equivalently as mu d, the average of the differences, is greater than 0. Since the claim is about the paired means and the standard deviation of the population of the differences is unknown, we will use the t procedure for one mean. Before we begin the two paired means t procedure, let's check if all necessary assumptions are satisfied. The sample must be assumed simple random. If not, then the results of the test are invalid. The central limit theorem must be applicable, so either the population must be normal or the sample size must be greater than 30. In our case, the sample size is less than 30, so we must assume that the population of differences is normally distributed. The population standard deviation must be unknown, but we can use the sample standard deviation instead. We will use the following template to perform the hypothesis testing. In step 1, we will set up the hypothesis. In step 2, we will identify the significance level. In step 3, we will find the test statistic using the formula. In step 4, we will perform either the critical value approach or p-value approach to test the claim. In step 5, we will draw the conclusion. And finally, in step 6, we will interpret the results. Since our claim, mu d is greater than 0, is in the form of an inequality, we are going to set it up as an alternative hypothesis. Therefore, the null hypothesis, which is always in the form of an equation, must be mu d equals 0. So the test is right-tailed. Step 1 is complete. The significance level can always be found in the text of the problem. In our case, it is 5%. Step 2 is complete. The test statistic can be computed using the formula. In our case, the test statistic T0 is equal to 9.391. Step 3 is complete. Next, we will test the hypothesis using two different approaches, the critical value and the p-value. In the critical value approach, we construct the rejection region. In this approach, we need to know the significance level alpha and the type of the test. We draw the rejection region under the student t probability density curve with 9 degrees of freedom, according to the type of the test. So right-tailed test will have the rejection region in the right tail. The region must have the area equal to the significance level 5%. The left boundary of the region is the critical value, T0.05, which is equal to 1.833. So the entire region can be described as the values to the right of 1.833. In p-value approach, we compute the p-value. In this approach, we need to know the test statistic and the type of the test. We find the p-value using the student t probability density curve with 9 degrees of freedom, according to the type of the test. So in the right-tailed test, the p-value is the area to the right of the test statistic. Symbolically, it can be expressed as the probability of t being greater than 9.391, which is effectively zero. Next, we are going to decide whether to reject or not reject the null hypothesis. In the critical value approach, we must check whether the test statistic is in the rejection region or not. Our test statistic is 9.391, and it is to the right of the critical value 1.833. Thus, it is in the rejection region. In the p-value approach, we must check whether the p-value is less than the significance level alpha. Our p-value is 0, and it is less than alpha. Both tests suggest that we do reject the null hypothesis in favor of the alternative. Next, we are going to interpret the results. Interpretation. Under 5% significance level, we do have sufficient evidence to suggest that the weekly earnings of small businesses have decreased during the pandemic. The hypothesis test is complete. I just showed how to apply the two-paired means t procedure to test a statistical claim about two-paired population means.